speed, 10.05.
When my bet was registered, an electrical message was sent to this machine. Once you've input the information, you can then process it. And that's what this is, a giant information processor. It's the Totalisator. It calculates the tote. It adds up all the bets that have come in on each dog, and then adds these together to get the grand total. Not only that, it calculates the odds. It does this by using cogs, differentials, and electrical relays. And it's been running reliably since 1928. What can this show us about the microchip? It doesn't work in quite the same way as the modern-day computer, but in many ways it's similar. Like the modern computer, it has input channels and memory. This input channel received the information about my bet. From here, it went to that machine over there, which adds up all the bets that have come in on dog number 5. My £1 bet was then added to the total, which is remembered here.
Okay, cut that. Okay, support that.
Processing or calculations, and other parts remember the result. memory is a crucial requirement. You need to have room to store the information you want to process and the instructions on how to do it. You also need to store bits of calculations while you're processing and the final result. In the modern day computer, there are two basic types of microchips, memory and processor chips. Now, we can easily remember a number or a letter. But how does an electrical circuit remember information? My £1 bet is then added to the total, which is remembered here. In this room, parts of the machine do the processing or calculations, other parts remember the results. Memory is a crucial requirement. You have to have room to store the information you want to process and the instructions on how to process it. You also need to store bits of your calculations while you're processing and the final result. In modern computers, there are two basic types of microchip, memory and processor chips, although some combine both in a single chip. Now, we can easily remember a letter or a number, but how do electrical circuits remember information?
And cut that.
Speed.
It's the Totalisator. It calculates the tote. It adds up all the bets that have come in on each dog, and then adds these together to get the grand total on all the dogs. Not only that, it calculates the odds. It does this by using Cobb's differentials and electrical relays. And it's been running reliably since 1928. Now what does this show us about the microchip? It doesn't work in quite the same way as the modern day computer, but in many ways it's similar. Like the modern computer, it has input channels and memory. This input channel received the information about my bet. From here, it went to that machine over there, which adds up all the bets that come in on gob number 5. My £1 bet was then added to the total, which is remembered here. In this room, parts of the machine do the processing or calculations, other parts remember the results. Memory is a crucial requirement. You have to have room to store the information you want to process and the instructions on how to do it. You also need to store bits of the calculations while you're processing and the final result. The modern day computer has two basic types of microchip, memory and processor chips. Now we can easily remember a number or a letter. But how do electrical circuits remember information?
That was lovely.
With mechanical technology, you can actually see processing taking place. While my £1 bet was being added up over there, a similar process was happening here. By a complicated system of rods and levers, that long rod was changing its angle. The shallower the slope of the rod, the worse the odds, so I get less of my dog ratings. The way electrical circuits process information is just as complicated, but there's much less to see.
And cut. Lovely.
Really.
Any full answer for it?
Cut.
That's level, I'm afraid.
Totalisator is what computing experts would call a dedicated real-time parallel processor. Like a modern computer, it has memory, the ability to do calculations, and to communicate with other devices. They call it dedicated because, like a custom chip designed for a specific purpose, it's hardwired into doing a specific job. You can't program it to do anything else. It's due to close soon. When they move to the new track, they won't be taking it with them, they'll be using microchips, so it'll be scrapped. One wonders if the new computer that will be taking over this job will last anything like a while. This chip can do all the calculations that this machine has done every race night for the past 60 years in a matter of seconds. Put it another way, to build a machine as powerful as this chip, you have to cover most of Harringay arena in literally tons of machinery. A human being can add up two figures in about the time it takes the greyhounds to get to the back stretch. By that time, this chip will have added together 50 million numbers. In terms of greyhounds, they would have had to have gone around the track 10 million times. Calculating at this rate, it would take 7 years do what the chip in the time it took the dogs to get to the back stretch.
And cut.
The Totalisator is what computing experts would call a dedicated real-time parallel processor. Like a modern computer, it has memory, the ability to do calculations, and communicate with other devices. They call it dedicated because, like a custom chip designed for a specific purpose, it's hardwired into doing a specific job. You can't program it to do anything else. It's about to close soon, and when they move to the new track, they won't be taking it with them, they'll be using microchips, so it'll be scrapped. One wonders if the new computer that will be taking over its job will last anything like as long. This chip can do all the calculations that this machine has done every race night for the past 60 years in a matter of seconds. Put it another way, in order to build a machine as powerful as this chip, you'd have to cover most of Harringay Stadium in literally tons of machinery. A human being can add up two figures in about the time it takes the greyhounds to get to the back straight. By that time, this chip would have added together 50 million numbers. In greyhound terms, they would have had to have gone round the track 10 million times. Calculating at this rate, it would take 7 years to do what the chip did in the time it took the dogs to get to the back straight.
And pause that. I'm turning my head that way.
Thank you.
you're telling that, are you?
Tripod.
when is that going to happen?
As soon as that light comes on. That's it.
Alright. Then is it imminent?
Well, it should be.
No. Will that start with
that? Yeah, let's cut that now. I don't know what you got.
It does on.
Yeah, that just come up.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Right. Save it.
Okay, yeah.
get it.
When those last clicks were going.
You could get him checking the machine.
Set this live, Kenny.
Right, good over 15.
still running.